Hi everyone, welcome to the first episode of Ask Alan. I'm Alan from Newlands Pets, and the idea behind this is that we answer the questions that people are asking, and with the hope that it helps lots of people. And I really think it will help loads and loads of people, because often the questions are quite similar. So let's get to it, and thank you for everyone who sent in questions. Thank you very much. So Helen asked, and this is one that actually Helen came into the shop and asked, is can I give my dog carrots? There's a slight caveat to this particular question, because in her case, the answer was no, but in 99% of every single dog's case, yes, the answer is yes, you can definitely give carrots as a treat. The reason that Helen couldn't was that we wanted to reduce the amount of sugars in the diet for the dog, and carrots are relatively high in sugar. Hence we can make cakes out of them. So that's why we said no in her particular case, but yeah, in 99% of the case you can definitely give carrots to dogs as a treat, no issue at all, and it's part of a lot of complete foods as well. So Zoe asked, and Zoe's been coming in for ages. I remember Yogi, was she asking a question about Yogi? It was a very, very small puppy when he came in. What is the best joint supplement that she can give Yogi? And Yogi's now five. Or should she wait until Yogi's older? And there is a follow-up as well. And there was a slight similar question that came from Charlotte from Instagram as well. Should I introduce joint supplements as a puppy, or wait until the dog's older? So from a puppy point of view, and I'll get to Yogi in a second for Zoe. From a puppy point of view, I personally wouldn't give supplements when they're like proper puppies, 10 week old, 11 week old and stuff like that. I personally wouldn't give supplements unless a vet is asking you to give supplements for whatever reason. But once we get to 10 months, 11 months, 12 months, when it comes to supplements, prevention is much better than cure. So the same as I have cod liver oil tablets for my joints, it's not because I have joint issues, it's because I don't want joint issues later. So I take that. So with dog supplements, the same is true. Now Yogi being five, Yogi is a shepherd, then definitely giving supplements is a good idea. And I believe she's given Umove, which is a great supplement to give your dog, and there's loads of alternatives. And she mentioned when she was last in about golden paste as well. And golden paste is a great supplement for joints and stuff for dogs. It's made from turmeric, so it's a really, really good supplement to give. So thanks for the questions, Charlotte and Zoe. Thank you very much. Natalie asked, what is the best alternative food to feed when you normally feed raw and you can't? For example, going away, traveling and stuff. And this is a question we get asked all the time this time of year. We've had 2 years where we didn't get asked it as much because no one could go on holiday. But now everyone's going away in caravans and going away on trips in this country. Then without a doubt, there's loads of great alternatives. First and foremost, I would actually say possibly best to see whether you can get away with feeding what you feed. So let's say you're going away for 4 days and maybe you can speak to where you're staying and you've got a little tiny freezer, or you can take, there's some fantastic cool boxes that will you can plug into the car. So feeding raw, I would always say if there's not a good reason to change, we try and advise people not to change. So if you can possibly feed raw, I'd continue. If you can't, and there's loads of examples where you can't, then there's freeze-dried, which is probably the closest nutritionally to raw. There's also high percentage meat kibble. You can see behind me 70, 60% meat. Often reflects exactly what is in raw food percentage of meat wise. So there's loads and loads of alternatives, plus there's wet food. I'd always go grain free. 99% of all raw is grain free. So I'd always go grain free if you possibly could. But freeze dried, if I was gonna pick one, I'd say freeze dried is the one to go for. Thanks for that question, Natalie. And lastly, Laura Clark underscore one from Instagram asked a question around about 10 minutes ago. How much should I feed a 2 kilo, 10-week-old puppy a day? Now, I didn't know the maths, which is why we create a booklet, which you can get from us in store. I'm making the assumption you're feeding raw. If you're not feeding raw, then the best thing to do is look at the bag or the packet. Even raw has a feeding guide on it 99% of the time as well. But if you're feeding raw, it's around about 180 grams a day, and that can be split up into, at 10 weeks, I'm assuming you're feeding 4 meals a day, can be split into 4 days. So around about 180 grams a day, split into four. And that concludes all the questions. So thank you very much for all the questions. We're going to be doing Ask Alan every single Thursday. So make sure you get any questions you want answered in. We are always here to help. See you soon.